وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، أما بعد. Today's beneficial chapter is a chapter from the Kitab Al-Kaba'ir by Imam Al-Dhahabi, The Major Sins. In it he mentions approximately 70 of the major sins, and with the evidences and explaining these major sins. And knowing the major sins is from the ilm al-awam, is one of the knowledge that the layman they need. Not only the layman, but everyone needs, but it's something that should be taught to the layman. And from this book, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to be taking one chapter only, short chapter, and that is the chapter of the ninth major sin. Remember, Dhahabi says, Al-Kabiratu al-Tasi'ah, the ninth major sin, Al-Kadhibu ala al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lying about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, lying about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam comes in different forms. From amongst them being a person making up a hadith. You don't know a hadith and you make it up. And it's something that is a huge, huge major sin. You say the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said something and he never said it. Or you make it up, you say the Prophet. And some scholars, they even say that if someone narrates a hadith and he knows it's a lie and he passes it on, فَهُوَ أَحَدُ الْكَاذِبِينَ, he's one of the liars as well against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So let's get into the chapter and see these hadith. Before that, one last surah, one last way of the people that they lie against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about Allah azza wa jalla as well, is when they speak about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without any knowledge. Person will come on social media and he'll give a fatwa on social media and answer. He'll say that this is halal, this is haram. And Allah says in the Quran, وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَا تَصِفُوا أَلْسِنَّتُكُمُ الْكَذِبَ هَذَا حَلَالٌ وَهَذَا حَرَامٌ. Don't say a lie against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying this is halal and this is haram. لِتَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبِ, making up things about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَفْتَرُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبَ لَا يَفْلِحُونَ. Those people who make up lies against Allah, they will never be successful. So speaking about the deen of Allah without having any knowledge, without being qualified to do so, is one of the major sins, and it comes under this as well. And Ibn Qayyim, he actually called the book, he says, إِعْلَامُ الْمُوَقِّعِينَ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. This is an announcement to those people, the signatories, on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on behalf of the Lord of the worlds. Speaking to the scholars, that you, when you speak about the deen of Allah, you are signing on behalf of Allah. You're saying, Allah said this is halal. Allah Azza wa Jal said this is haram. So what about someone who's jahil, ignorant? Ignorant person speaking about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying this is halal, this is haram, this person's a Muslim, this person's a kafir, this person's an innovator, this person's misguided, this is a sin, this is not a sin, this is halal, haram. This is from the worst things that a person can do. So what does the author say here? الكذب على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كفر ينقل عن الملة. Lying about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is disbelief and takes you out of the fold of Islam. But not all the time. Speaking about it, it says ولا ريب أن تعمد الكذب على الله ورسوله. No doubt, if a person intentionally lies about Allah and His Messenger في تحليل الحرام أو تحريم حلال كفر, lying about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in making something halal that the Prophet made haram, or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it halal, or Allah azza wa jalla made it halal and you make it haram, and you know that and you do it on purpose, this is what he means by this is kufr. To say that this is halal, say alcohol is halal, for example, kufr billahi azza wa jalla. Wa innama ash-sha'nu fi al-kadhib alayhi fi siwa dhalik. But what we're talking about here in this chapter is to lie about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in other than that, not in halal and haram. You say this is halal whilst you know it's haram. This is disbelief, this is kufr, not just a major sin. You know it's haram and you say it's halal. This is disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for someone in other than that, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن كذبا علي ليس ككذب على غيري. Lying about me is not about, it's not the same as lying about someone else. Why? Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when you lie about him صلى الله عليه وسلم, rules come out of it. If you say the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said and he never said it, then based on this, some will say, based on this, this is halal. Based on this, this is haram. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam carries on and he says in the hadith, which is mutawatir, narrated from multiple sources, from the companions, one of the mutawatir hadith, he says, مَنْ كَذَبَ عَلَيَّ مُتَعَمِّدًا فَلْيَتَبَوَّأْ مَقَعَدَهُ مِنَ النَّارِ. Whoever lies about me on purpose, then let him take his place in the hellfire. وقال, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من كذب علي بني له بيت في جهنم. Whoever lies about me, then a house in the hellfire will be built for him. And Imam al-Dhahabi said, this is an authentic hadith. وقال, من يقول عني ما لم أقل فليتبوأ مقعده من النار. Whoever says about me something that I didn't say, let him take his place in the hellfire. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is narrated that he said, المؤمن يطبع المؤمن على كل شيء إلا الخيانة والكذب. That the believer naturally the believer, he can be made naturally created on anything except for lying, except for treachery and lying. The believer doesn't lie. And what do you think about the one who lies about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, من روى عني حديثا وهو يرى أنه كذب فهو أحد الكذابين. Whoever narrates from me a hadith and he believes that it is a lie, or it is known that this hadith is a lie, and he doesn't tell the people that this is a lie, rather he makes a lie about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فهو أحد الكذابين, then he is one of the liars. One of the people, those people who used to make up lies about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أخزاه الله عز وجل, it was said that one of the people in the marketplace, they wouldn't be able to sell trousers. And so he went to the sheikh, or this sheikh, and he said to him, can you tell the people to buy trousers? Make them buy trousers? So the Prophet, he said the hadith, he said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, may Allah have mercy upon the one who wears trousers. And this is the lies that people, they started making lies about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in order to gain something min hutam al-dunya, from this worldly gains. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from such evil. If he believes, he knows it's a lie, then this person, he is also from one of the liars. So if you hear this hadith now, and then you hear this hadith, and you know it's a lie, and then you narrate it to someone else, whilst knowing it's a lie, or it is said that it's a lie, then this person, no doubt he comes under this hadith, فهو أحد الكذابين, he's one of the liars against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam al-Dhahabi says, فَلَا حَلَكَ بِهَذَا أَنَّ رِوَايَةَ الْمَوْضُوعِ لَا تَحِلْ. From this you understand that narrating the made-up hadith, fabricated hadith, موضوع hadith, is not allowed. This is what Imam al-Dhahabi says. But I want to add on to the speech of Imam al-Dhahabi certain points that are needed for every single Muslim today. From amongst the things that some of the scholars, they put under lying against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is if a person, he narrates a hadith, and he narrates it in a wrong way. يعني, he says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. He says, that's the hadith, right? He says it in a wrong way, accidentally, because of his own fault, because he didn't memorize it properly. He wasn't sure, but he said it anyway. That's why Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he would narrate a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would add to the end, oh kama qal, oh how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it. He wouldn't narrate it because he's scared maybe he might get one lafz, one wording wrong. So he would say the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this, oh kama qal, oh something similar to that. One wording. So what about someone, he says, the Prophet sallallahu, I'm not sure about the hadith, I haven't memorized it properly, but he just narrates it. And he doesn't even say that something like that or something similar to that. He doesn't even make clear that go research the wording, maybe I've got it wrong. No, he just says it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. What also comes under this is someone who knows the hadith is weak and he just narrates it without clarifying that this hadith is weak. Some of the Salaf, they would say, من أسند, whoever brings the chain of narration, he brings the chain of narration, then that person he's okay. Because he brought the chain of narration, now it's upon you, the one who's listening or the one who's reading, to go and research in that chain of narration, is it authentic or not? But other than that, narrating a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you're not sure if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said it or not, is something that's very dangerous. Imam Ahmed rahimahullah ta'ala, he would not narrate a hadith unless he heard it 3 times. When he would hear a hadith, he would write a circle. In the circle, he would write a dot next to the hadith. When he would hear it the second time, he would write a dot. When he would hear it the third time, he would write a dot. And then he would narrate this hadith. Because then he's sure that this is how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said it. Being careful on how we narrate the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, something that's lost in a lot of people today. Because everyone wants to speak about the deen of Allah azza wa jal without any knowledge. What also comes under this is making a ruling, this is halal and this is haram. Saying something is halal and saying something is haram. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, "Man 'alima shay'an falyaqul bihi." If you know something, say it. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَعْلَمْ فَلْيَقُلْ اللَّهُ عَلَمْ. Oh, لا أدري. He said, if you don't know, then say Allah knows best, or say I don't know. Because part of knowledge is to say for something that you don't know, I don't know. If you don't know something, say I don't know. And that's why Imam Malik or some of the scholars, they'll say, لا أدري نصف العلم. Saying I don't know is half of knowledge. Why is it half of knowledge? It's because at least now you know you don't know. Some people, they don't know, but they don't even know they don't know. They think they know. As for the person who doesn't know, and he knows he doesn't know, then at least he's got half of knowledge. أَلَّا أَدْرِي نِصْفَ الْعِلْمِ. So my brothers and sisters, this short chapter is to give you this fear about speaking in the deen of Allah Azza wa Jal. Lying about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is not a small sin. مَنْ كَذَّبَ عَلَيَّ مُتَعَمِّدًا فَلْيَتَبَوَّأْ مَقْعَدَهُ مِنَ النَّارِ. Whoever lies about me on purpose, then let him take his place in the hellfire. Ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala أن يزيدنا علما, to increase us in knowledge and actions, and to increase us in wara, fear of Allah that stops us from doing anything that is even close to haram. Wallahu a'lam, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.